Hello everyone, Ken here, back with a new video for you. Today I'm talking about my 5 tips related to data science internships. A couple of them are related to how to actually get that internship, and a couple of them are about how to get the most out of your position. If you're new to my channel, I produce data science content, making the field that's accessible to everyone. If you enjoy this video, please hit that like button, and if you'd like to see more content like this, please subscribe to my channel. My first tip for getting a data science internship is for you not to freak out over the technical aspects. I get a lot of questions, and I see a lot of questions in forums about what languages should I learn, how much do I need to know, should I know this, should I know this, and should I know this. For most data science internships, you'll probably need a foundational understanding of Python or R and the ability to do some SQL querying. I think it's a huge benefit if you have exposure to some of the packages in Python that are used routinely. So scikit-learn, pandas, numpy, scipy, etc. But beyond that, most internship employers are really not looking for too much. They're looking for someone that is excited about the position, that's teachable, and that is energetic. With that being said, my second tip is to actually really focus on applying to positions that excite you. When you're interning, you get to explore a bunch of different fields, you get to experiment with what you like, and the more passionate you are about a field, the more you're willing to put in, the more you're willing to learn. So if you learn data science through the lens of a certain industry, through a certain project type, to me that's the best way, because you're going to be really engaged, especially if it's something that you absolutely love. So I learned data science through working with sports data for the most part. It's something I'm super passionate about, it's something that I am always thinking about, and to combine those fields, it created a huge surplus for me. I would recommend trying to do the same thing yourselves. Data science internships are a learning experience, and you should be trying to get the most out of your position. It's not just about having an internship, it's also thinking about what type of work you'll be doing when you're actually at the company. So I've actually had better experiences at smaller companies. I've interned at a Fortune 100 company, as well as a couple startups. And at the startups, you get to work on a lot more diverse projects, you get to be involved in the business process, you get to kind of touch everything. And to me, that's a lot more fun. At large organizations, you get to see how processes work and how data science fits into the bigger picture. But in college, at a younger age or at an earlier level, I don't find that quite as useful. My third tip is to use the resources that are readily available to you to reach out and to get on people's radar. So most colleges, most universities have a job board. Really check that out. I would also use your social network, your LinkedIn network, to find out what's out there. Reddit is also a great resource. There's plenty of jobs, data and science internship jobs, that are not on any posting board or that are on very obscure posting boards. I talk in some of my previous videos about how it's pretty expensive to put a job posting on LinkedIn, so you won't necessarily always see every position there. I also think you should reach out to companies that you're just generally interested in to see if they have something that isn't posted or that they're going to post. When I was in grad school, I reached out to DraftKings. It was a company I was crazy about. I was using their product all the time, and they didn't have an internship position available for me. But after some conversation, after addressing my skill set and some of their needs, we were able to build a position for me for that summer, which I think a lot of people don't believe that's an option, and it really is. My next tip is don't be afraid to work for free. Now, you might say, oh, I want to get paid for a data science internship. Usually that's one of the benefits of interning over the summer, is you accumulate some cash. But there's a ton of benefits of doing free work. It's not necessarily always free work for a company, but free work in your own time working on a project makes you a lot more interesting and valuable to organizations hiring for internships. If you were to work for free for one of these internships, an unpaid internship, there's a ton of benefits of that as well. You can work on projects that might be cooler, you can work in environments more of your choosing, and, you know, for example, I did an internship for one of my buddies when I was really early in college, and I was able to work on every part of the organization. There were no limits on my projects because I had vetted the position. I said, these are the things that I want to do. And they went along with it because an extra pair of hands for free is great. You know, why not have that person work on really cool and interesting things? It gives you a lot more control over where you go and what you work on. So it's something to consider, especially if you're kind of late in the process and you don't have anything lined up. My last tip is really the most important one for actually getting a data science internship. And it comes in two parts. So the first is showcase your work, and the second is to tell really good stories about yourself and about why you want the position. So showcasing your work means that you have to have a GitHub, you have to have something on the internet that shows who you are and what you do. And it should be really well manicured. You shouldn't have any mistakes in there. Because whenever I see a new candidate, I Google them, I go on LinkedIn, I sometimes even go on Facebook if they're available because I want to get to know that person. So we'll make sure that's well manicured. But also, if I see someone with a lot of information out there on them, especially if it's positive information, research, etc., I'm generally really impressed. I have good talking points for when I'm interviewing them, and just that general sense that someone is building their capital is a really good feeling for me. The second part about storytelling is people are always compelled by an interesting story. And if you can explain to me why my company is special to you and how you can provide value to my company, there's a really good chance that even if you're a little bit lacking on the technical skills, or you don't have any experience in the industry, I would still consider taking you for that position. Again, the bar is a little bit lower on internships. You're expecting people to learn, and you're not always expecting them to create a ton of value. So if you can explain to me why this position is, you know, your dream position and why you think your skills would be a revenue driver for our company, absolutely puts you into the consideration set. An example would be that if I was applying to a sports analytics company, or let's say a baseball analytics company in general, I could talk about how I grew up playing baseball. I was going to play in college, and you know, I fell in love with the numbers when I took an economics course. And why baseball statistics is really important to me is when I was playing, I was one of the few players that was actually keeping my own numbers. And going forward, I'd like to, you know, my playing days are over, but I'd like to continue that spirit by being able to tackle these types of questions. So that is something that gets them interested, it shows you're interested, and it shows why this unique field is valuable to you. Thank you so much for watching. As usual, good luck with your data science journey.